You're watching an hour of Tool on Channel V. For a band as dark as Tool, they maintain a strangely optimistic outlook on life.
I think we're all pretty optimistic about where humanity's going. It's going onward and upward, you know, at a snail's pace, but I think it is going the right direction. It's just, it takes a while, but, you know, if you look back, you can see we're in a better place now, I think, than we were. You know, the conservatives, weirdos, you know, were trying to hold everybody down in the 50s were a lot worse than the people who are trying to do that now. You know, a lot more things you could get accepted all the time, and you know, people are communicating a little better all the time. The net of communication all over the planet's getting better, and it has to, or we won't survive. You know, people have to become aware of the problems, and then they hopefully will get solved, you know, but I don't think anybody wants to commit suicide, you know, and all it takes is awareness to prevent that.
For a band who spends a lot of energy avoiding the spotlight, one wonders why Tool choose to call Los Angeles home.
If you're trying to raise a family, it's a bad place, but if you have a vision, there's a lot of resources here to, you know, see that vision through. So it's a good place for that. And other than that, I wouldn't recommend it.
Pretty much everyone here is here to work. You know, it's just a working environment. It's, the whole town is set up around this entertainment industry. And,
The weather's nice.
Yeah.
That and just, you know, you got to figure if people like us weren't doing it, who would be? You know, you kind of have to, like, stay here just to at least represent your ideas, because otherwise, you know, the mediocre stuff will just march in to take your place, because there's only so many magazine covers, so many video shows, you know, so many spots on MTV, so many spots on the rack at Walmart, you know, so they're gonna fill a hole. So if nobody's representing some higher ideals or really trying to push the art to a new level, it doesn't matter. Somebody's gonna fill in the space and it'll be mediocre, so somebody's gonna do it.
Heavy music has changed considerably in the 10 years of Tool's existence. What do Tool think of the new breed of sports metal acts with their big shorts and accompanying DJs such as Linkin Park?
It's kind of hard to really put those things in a category of band. It's more like a... You almost have to... If there's like another Billboard chart...
Are they a boy band?
No, they're like... Slip Biscuit or whatever that stuff is. There should be like a separate Billboard chart that has to do with clever marketing plans, you know, so like McDonald's be right up there with McNuggets, then like, you know, those bands you mentioned would be up there. That's how those should be rated. That's that kind of a chart. It shouldn't really be, they should really be on a music chart.
You're watching an hour of Tool on Channel V. 5 years after releasing their debut EP Opiate, Tool disappeared without a trace. In a nutshell, their record company went broke and was taken over. The new executives didn't approach Tool about recording another album, despite the band's old contract stating they had 7 months to do so. And so, Tool thought they were free agents. Tool began to make plans for the future, but when their new record company got wind of it, they sued for breach of contract. Tool sued back, and years were eaten up in a lengthy court battle, while the band kept busy on tours and other projects, such as Maynard's side project, A Perfect Circle.
It wasn't so much really a five-year wait. It was, you know, we made a record, and we toured on it for about 2 years. Got into some legal hassles. Needed a short break. I started working with my roommate Billy Howardell on A Perfect Circle, and that took off way more than we thought it was going to take off. So, I mean, you kind of have to give it, you know, it's due, so we just kind of use that as a use that as our break. And that was only for like 9 months or a year. So the actual break that we took was when I was off with Perfect Circle, and then we got right back to work and record's done.
We're keeping busy in our different ways, you know. We all have projects we have working on, you know. I mean, Adam's doing nonstop art, you know, and I'm always jamming with different friends and whatnot, you know. But I mean, 5 years is a while, you know, when it goes by. And I think if anything, we probably just learned a lot more about each other and how to get along and keep the band together, you know. This is a lot more than all of our contemporaries did, pretty much, who started out the same time as us. Rage, Helmet, Soundgarden, Nirvana, you know, pretty much everyone from that era is gone now except us.
We just kind of pulled the secret maneuver that none of them really did. Like a process of communication. There's a whole band dedicated to the idea. It's called Circle Jerks. We all just got naked and worked it out.